So you've come to the conclusion that it's time to automate processes in your business. But where do you go from here? The next step should be documenting processes so that you can identify which ones you want to automate first, second, and third. But this can be a daunting process, but I want to show you an easy process to do this where you're not drawing a crazy mind map to figure out what everything does in your business. Instead, it's a simple document you can fill out and then take to someone like me or an agency to help you build those automations. My name is Andy O'Neill, and I help entrepreneurs like you add time-saving automation to their business. I'm going to be showing you my recommended way of documenting automations. And this is one of the sections out of my ebook called Automate Your Business in 3 Simple Steps. This is one of the steps there. And if you want this ebook, you can click this link to get that. The first step here is to understand triggers. This is a make scenario, and my trigger here is where I'm watching an RSS feed. In this use case, when there's a new RSS feed item, which could be a blog post or a recipe off of a website or a podcast episode, this scenario is going to run and do these different steps. There's lots of steps in here that this runs and does. If you're familiar with Zapier, it's going to look like this. And this top one right here, new email matching a particular search, this is the trigger for my Zapier Zap. So the first step in documenting your business processes is to think about the trigger. What is the trigger? Is it an invoice is created? A new order comes in on your online store? A form is submitted on your website? Some other examples are a new order is placed or an email is received, or just a specific date and time occurs. The first of the month, you want to run an automation that creates a report for the previous month. Once you understand the triggers in your business, you need to think about the actions that happen when those triggers happen. When an order comes in, what are the automatable steps that you can do for fulfilling that order? When a form is submitted on your website, what happens next? Think about the steps or the actions that happen after that business trigger. So I'm going to jump over here to a Google document that I've linked in the video in the description, or you can click right here to get that. This is the documentation format that I recommend to my clients. It is not scary. It is not a crazy mind map. You don't have to go mind mapping everything. It simply says, what's the automation name? What is the trigger for this automation? And what actions happen when that trigger is triggered? So if you look here, we have the automation name is a new order from WooCommerce. The automation trigger is, this is a new order of physical goods. So somebody goes to your website and they order 5 t-shirts. So what are the things that happen within your team if this were to be the trigger? You're going to have to generate a shipping label. We're going to have to print that shipping label, create an invoice in QuickBooks, apply a payment in QuickBooks. So these are the steps that can generally be automated when an order is placed. Let's go down here to another example where you have a website contact form that has been submitted. So your trigger is the contact form is submitted. Your actions, for example, could be to add a user to an email list. That can be completely automated. Add a ticket to a ticketing system like Freshdesk. That can be automated. And to add a user interaction to your CRM, such as HubSpot. There's lots of other steps that could be added here. But the idea I hope you're getting is this doesn't have to be a complex process to document the things you want to automate within your business. The next step would be building your automations. And there's a lot of ways to go about this. You can go the DIY route. Maybe you have somebody who's technical on your team, or maybe you're technical and you want to take this on yourself. The other option is you want to farm this out to an agency. The third option, and this is where I typically find myself working with clients, is doing co-building calls. And a co-building call is where we literally book a time together, an hour or 2 hours at a time. We get on a Zoom call, just like kind of like this, and we work on and build your automations together. What that does for the business owner is it creates knowledge inside the business, either for the business owner or that key person that's technical that would be building these. It also creates transparency so that the team inside the business knows how these work. They know how they function, and they can have great, intelligent conversations with the co-builder on what needs to happen and what needs to change. Again, this is a great option for business owners who like to be able to see everything that's going on in their business. Regardless of which option you choose, I would love to hear your comments in the description. Was this video valuable? And you can always reach out to me to schedule a co-building call or even just an automation strategy call to look at your documentation and see what your next steps might need to be. I appreciate you watching the video, and I will see you next time.